Get easier. Ooh, child, things will get brighter. Someday, yeah, we'll get it together and we'll get it all done. Someday, when you're feeling much stronger. Someday, yeah, we'll walk in the rays of a beautiful sun. Someday, when the world is much brighter. Gonna be easier. Ooh, child, things will be brighter. Today, yeah, we got it together and we're showing it soon. Today, when my worries much lighter.
People, people, presenting, prepared, polished, professional, and prompt, the Purple Team!
We are thrilled to introduce Lilac, a breastfeeding aid to promote intimacy between mothers and their babies who could not otherwise breastfeed. Due to issues such as cleft palate or tongue tie, 1 in 6 babies struggles to breastfeed. This means hundreds of thousands of mothers who wish to provide breast milk for their child have no choice but to pump and bottle feed, which many say is less intimate than direct nursing. We spoke to over 40 mothers about their experiences pumping and heard breastfeeding difficulties described as devastating. One mother lamented that it felt like a rejection and made her feel guilty for being unable to provide for her child, and others described it as devastating. It was for these mothers that we created Lilac. One of the mothers we worked with, Carolyn, let us record her experiences feeding her son Finn before Lilac. Since birth, Finn has had a tongue tie, extra tissue beneath his tongue that prevented him from breastfeeding. Though it was surgically corrected when Finn was 9 months old, at nearly 11 months, Finn continues to rely on bottle feeding. Mothers like Carolyn, who exclusively pump milk, describe the experience as being tied to a machine for an average of 6 sessions a day. This robs mothers of time with their babies. While Carolyn pumps, she is physically separated from her son, Finn.
We are so excited to have Carolyn and Finn here today to demonstrate Lilac. Before Lilac, Carolyn and Finn were unable to breastfeed. As you can see, Lilac allows Carolyn to pump and feed Finn at the same time. She holds him close to her body, restoring the intimacy of natural breastfeeding. Carolyn, what has your experience been like feeding Finn with Lilac?
I wish I'd had this 10 months ago after thinking of how much time was spent on the machine rather than with my baby.
Thank you. Thanks, Finn. We're so grateful that you could be here tonight. Let's give Carolyn and Finn one last round of applause. Let's take a closer look at how Carolyn uses Lilac. First, she attaches the plastic nipple onto the device housing. This off-the-shelf nipple is designed to release milk with a gentle pinch only for babies who cannot naturally suckle. It is positioned at an angle such that Carolyn can hold Finn with maximum skin-to-skin contact, as if she were breastfeeding without assistance. Next, Carolyn inserts Lilac into her maternity bra to secure the device to her breast. A soft silicone flange creates the vacuum seal, providing added comfort and size customization. The transparent housing allows Carolyn to properly align her nipple. It also provides real-time feedback on milk flow and consumption, because parenting is stressful enough without having to worry if your child has enough to eat. Finally, Carolyn attaches the tube and turns on the pump, which begins to apply suction. Two one-way valves and a diaphragm prevent milk from flowing back up into the suction mechanism. With Lilac, Carolyn begins feeding Finn. We've adapted an existing pump to include a custom feedback system to prevent milk waste. It does this by balancing the baby's feeding rate with the mother's pumping rate. If Finn is feeding slower than Carolyn is pumping, milk will build up in the reservoir. When milk reaches this height, around an ounce, it blocks the view of a phototransistor. This instructs the pump to turn off. As Finn continues to feed, milk falls below the level of the sensor, and the pump turns back on. After feeding, Carolyn disassembles Lilac to easily clean the dishwasher-safe components. Finn is happy and fed, and the two of them have shared another cherished moment together.
Parents should be empowered for how they feed their baby, whether it be direct nursing, pumped milk, or formula. Lilac offers another option as the only device that restores intimacy between mother and baby. Here's how we plan to put Lilac into the hands of parents. In the first year, we will improve our design, file a patent, and apply for FDA approval as a Class II medical device. In year two, we will launch our product in the Boston area via direct online sales. Boston's leading medical services will allow us to reach families in need through lactation experts. We will then expand to the whole US market in year three, focusing on regions with leading children's hospitals and postnatal care centers to reach a target market of 500,000 families. We project Lilac can drive revenue to $2.1 million by year three. Each unit will cost $48 to manufacture and will retail online for $400, comparable to high-end breast pumps. We will seek insurance assistance because recent healthcare mandates have broadened coverage for maternity care. We price Lilac because the value that our users place in our specialized product. One mother we spoke to stated that she would buy our product for $1,000 twice if it meant more time bonding with her baby. No mother should be limited to exclusively pumping or bottle feeding their baby. Lilac, giving mother and child the intimate nursing experience they deserve.
Thank you. Purple team, do we have a question? Yep.
Yeah. Hi. So compared to other breast pumps, breastfeeding pumps on the market, how much does it weigh? Because I'm assuming mothers will want to carry this around and be able to go out and about.
Thank you so much for the question. So currently, Lilac weighs approximately 150 grams, which is slightly heavier than current breast pumps, but at full production and better manufacturing methods, we believe that we can optimize the weight and get it close to current weights of current breast pumps in the market.
Oh, to clarify that, our attachment device is, as what John said, is 150 grams. Our pump is 800 grams.
Thank you. Question over here.
Is it a rechargeable device or do you have to plug it in?
As of currently, we have to plug it into the wall, but in future iterations, we would like for it to be portable and rechargeable.
Thank you. Question over here.
Does the pump double as a normal breastfeeding pump, or can you only use it when the child's hungry?
Thank you for that question. We're looking forward to exploring new avenues in the future with the product. With this iteration, we mainly focused on feeding from the mother directly to the baby. So this current iteration can't do that. However, we anticipate it being a pretty easy upgrade to be able to use it as a normal breast pump.
As a user, the last ounce is still in there, and it's very easy to just squeeze that right out into the bottle. So I could see myself being lazy enough to just continue pumping and manually putting it in the bottle. So.
Question here in the front.
Hi, most breast pumps are provided, often covered by insurance companies as durable goods. Have you reached out to any insurance companies to look into that, see if they would, that's something that they would be covered?
Yeah, that's a great question and definitely something that we've been considering. We haven't actually reached out to any insurance companies. However, researching current insurance coverage, they cover many breast pumps up to around $250 to $300. So we believe our product may achieve at least partial coverage.
Thank you. Question in the back. Yep.
How easy is it to clean if a mother is using it outside of home, for example, like at the workplace or in a public place?
The current design of Lilac has been designed so it's as intimate as possible. You can see that through the small dimensions. It's actually smaller than the attachment for a normal pump. However, the pump itself, the motor, is not portable yet, and that's something that we're looking to explore in future iterations.
Thank you. I have a question. The mic's coming to you. Yep.
Hello, I have a couple questions. One, I just wanted you guys to expand maybe on the electronics and like the software of like your device. And also I was wondering like if it, like is it all potentially dangerous for the babies like in use?
Thank you so much. I can answer the first part of the question. So we currently modify an off-the-shelf pump. We intercept the power source by using a relay connected to a microcontroller. And our microcontroller is connected to QTR1A phototransistors, which read IR. And based on these signals, we can know when milk blocks the photoresistor. Then it tells our microcontroller that milk is blocking. And then we tell the pump to shut off without having to turn off the logic board of the existing off-the-shelf pump.
To answer the second part of that question, also again, thank you for the great question. If you're worried about the radiation coming from the phototransistors, it's equivalent to the radiation coming from, let's say, a remote controller, so it's within the safe range.
Thank you. That's all we have time for. Thank you, Purple Team.